See, dude? Happy holidays. Go full circle, bro. Full circle, homie. No, we took that shit to a party, dude. I did. No way, bro. If the two of us had finished that pan, bro, we'd both be dead of heart attacks. Nah, man. We took that shit to a party. And like I said, it made me rethink my entire fucking eating habits. Since making that, this year has been a year of like much healthier eating habits. I think it, I mean, it just shows in my fucking face, dude. But yeah, like I'm easily 20 pounds lighter than I was in that video at this point because that shit was raw. That shit was raw as fuck, man. That shit was some burly ass stuff. Nah, we took it to a party. People ate most of it, and I think I had like one or two more pieces, but it was still, it was so fucking rich, dude. That shit was deadly. It was good. It was good. It was a layer of fucking thick brownie with a mint cream layer, and then that thick chocolate butter shit on the top, man. It was fucking delicious, but it was terrible for you. So, let's take a look at, That'll work. All right, let's take a look at the disappearance of something something. Vanishing of Ethan Carter. Let me get my Twitch shit updated before people freak out, because everybody freaks out. You know how people freak out, bruh. Dirk, you know how they be freaking. Something something. The vanish. Here we go. Oops. Come on.
But seeing there were mentions of things no little boy should know about. There are places that exist that very few people can see. Ethan could have drawn a map. I hadn't entered Red Creek Valley yet, but already I could feel its darkness reaching out for me. Finding Ethan Carter wasn't going to be as easy as knocking on his door. I was too late for that. To find Ethan, I had to figure out what this place was trying to hide from me.
It was delicious, man. Don't get me wrong. It was fucking delicious. But, bro, it was a. Whoops. It was definitely not the kind of meal you can you want to even try and finish between two people, or the tray of fucking brownies that you even want to try and finish between two people, because it would have been some devastating shit. Pretty, man. Hold on, I gotta fuck with it for a second, cuz. First, I gotta turn this off. Boom. Nice and smooth.
Red Creek Valley seemed like a quiet, ordinary place. I've learned two things in my life. No place is truly quiet, and nowhere is really ordinary.
Just an ordinary quiet place, except for those two things don't exist.
By what I saw here, he didn't need to worry. I've worked dozens of cases, hundreds. This would be my last one. Already I knew that.
Game froze up? Well, that's ghetto. Hold on a sec. Okay, game. Why you freeze up? Why you freeze up? What is going on there? What's it capturing over there? Oh, yeah. There we go. Ethan. Ah. There we go. That ought to do a little bit better. Oh, that's where we came from. Or is that? Yeah, OBS is just not digging me right now. But, what are you gonna do, man? It's OBS for you. Neat. It makes me think of like mist. Ooh, VR, dude. Hell yeah. That's wicked. I need a good VR setup. Ah, we had that conversation already though, man, so. Yep, that's rope, all right. Oh, that's his legless body. Fractured skull. Not yet. Don't touch his body. Stop messing with him. Ooh, let me touch it. Let me touch it. Let me touch it. Let me touch it. Oh, can't jump to my death. What a bitch. Probably starvation. And then later they came along and ate his legs off. The wolves, that is. Oh, sweet, dude. Yeah, I need that. Give me that grip. Let's go for a swim. No swim? Okay, no swim. I'm gonna turn off the motion blur. Did I actually do it? No, I didn't. Yeah, there we go. That's less. Did I just walk on water? What can I say? Ethan Carter and Jesus? Just like Jesus and Luke Skywalker, they got some things in common. There you go. There's some Mandela effect stuff. Luke Skywalker's actually Jesus. Now he is, because I've changed it. I've changed the nature of the universe. Nothing? Changed the nature of the whole universe just now, dude. Nelson Mandela is Luke Skywalker. Say what? Nah, for real. That's for real now. That's really what's going on in the world. Clue glowing over here. Is it a body? Is it a person? It's a... Oh. What the hell is that? What the crap? Bola? Hey, come on, dude. Come back, Spaceman Spiff. Ass back over here, Spaceman Spiff. Spaceman Spiff! This is pretty cool graphics, dude. Oh, I think we did determine that, but I think we're still gonna go and verify it. Make sure Spaceman Spiff doesn't have more to tell us about it. Spaceman Spiff is actually Luke Skywalker, which means he's actually Nelson Mandela, which means he's actually Luke Skywalker and Jesus. Which means that Darth Vader is actually God. And there were 6 people in the car that JFK was shot in. Not Debbie Does Dallas. Oh, that's too bad. I was really hoping for some porno scares. Oh shit, porno scare! Get on it! Yeah, what up? Porno scare. Let's go, zap! Sweet, I'm in the zapper. Oh, loving in the zapper time. We're gonna go train Dragon Ball Z style. Oh, fuck yeah. This is the part where we train for 6 months at 14 times Earth's gravity. Neat. Dude, what do you mean not Debbie Dizels? Look at this shit, bro. 14 times gravity. Alright. Let me put my arm weights on. Debbie Does Dallas. Debbie Does. Debbie's actually Jesus. I'm getting a Dragon Ball Z vibe. Sweet, bro. Cosmic. Debbie might not have, but Luke did. And Nelson Mandela definitely did that karate, bro. Now Debbie did karate. Debbie was a karate master now. Yep, that's right. We just changed it up, bro. Just changed the whole reality. Now Debbie was a fucking karate master, and that's why she was doing what she was doing. She was doing it all for her karate techniques. Now you know. Debbie was obese too? Or who's obese? I'm obese in the capsule now? Because 14 times gravity, right? Yeah, I hear you, dude. It's tough on the knees. Oh no, I want to. Hey, I wanted to read that. Fuck, I forgot to read that shit. Let me read it. Damn it. Give me it back.
I liked the beast.
Fuck.
At least he gets to leave this goddamn place.
Yeah, the beast was alright too. Oh, here we go. Alright, you just read that shit. I meant to, bro. I just hit the wrong button. Damn, sorry. You know what? I did read it, bro. Now I'm changing it up, man. I did read it. I know exactly what happened on that. Which means now I really do know exactly what happened to it, and it was all about the Fang and the Beast. So, see, dude? All you gotta do is change your reality. All of a sudden, I'm smoking a cigarette, you know what I'm saying? Beast will never use its fangs again, bro.
Sweet.
There's something on the back? Yes, there is. Here we go. See, I told you, man. All I had to do was remember that I had read it. And boom, now here I am. I'm able to read it because fucking changed reality. Just like that. Changed the reality of the game. Blam. Alright, the beast. Where am I in? Is just a weird tree stand? Now we're playing the hunter. Bring me a buck. Does the hunter look this good? DE? Does the hunter look this good? Huh? Huh? I can't hear you. Or can I? Sit on the bench until the time. This is a really pretty game, though. I'll walk on the path instead of on the railroad like a chump. I ain't trying to chump this up, dude. I ain't trying to chump this up. Cool, a house thing.
No trains have been through here for a long time. That was part of a pattern. Large pieces of this country were thrown away, doomed to become, and then remained the worst versions of themselves. Beneath all that rot, dark things grow.
That's sad. Is there caves? Cave systems to explore? No. No cave systems. No deer either. Ooh, jump off the... Oh, no jumping off the rocks to your death. I'm over here scroll wheeling. One of these is gonna have the action menu on them. Nope, no action menu here. Oh, cool, a bridge.
I've seen every version of people hurting each other, hurting themselves. And they blame it on compulsion, selfishness, madness. I suppose the idea is, if you name a thing, you can control it. There are things in this world that cannot be named.
No jump. Whoa, check that out down there. That's fucking pretty as hell. I named that place Pinderschlosh. Yep. It's named. It's been named, yo. It's been named. I don't know what to name that thing, though, so. It'll just stay one of the unnameable things that you can't name. Not even by calling it the unnameable thing. I'm going up this hill. Pinderschlosh. Yeah, dude. Now let's go down to Castle Pinderschlosh and chill there. Or I guess we could go to this house. Sweet! I invoke the Boneless One, the One of the Voids, destroyer of ships, and he who is feared by the winds. Hear me. Great Minister of Folklore, I wish to make a pact with you to confound my enemies and protect my possessions. Use the doors of confusion to cloud their judgment. Stop barking, dogs. Seal the path with falsity and guile, and permit only those who can discern every true interior to pass. Alglon, Tetragram, Vachon, Stimulamaton. What the fuck? Wow. Okie dokie. I want to take it. How do I take it? Oh, I just invoked some fucking magic, dude. Changed reality by reading that page. I'm going to check out the rest of this little ghetto-ass house before I walk through the fucking portal of Mandela effect. Portal. Mandela portal. Stimulaton. Stimulatabon. Oh, look, there's another Mandela effect portal. Alright, let's do it. Zoop. Oh, I Mandela'd. Fuck, bro. This shit's getting real as fuck right now. Mandela'd. Oh, what? There's a button on it? Swap. Whoa, what? Dude. Whichever reality you perceive on the other side of the portal is the reality that you step into. That's fucking deep shit, bro. Alright, let's go back into this. Yeah, I'll go here. Sup, bitches? I'm in the attic. Sup, bitches? Where's the bodies at? Is that a body? Nope, that's nothing. Okay, now we're back in the original room. You gotta read the text, say it out loud. Put it back. Boom. Open up the portals to another dimension. Trip, dude. Stimulatonanon. Something of a stimulonaton.
Shimmy, shimmy, y'all, shimmy, yeah, shimmy, yay. Give me the portal so I can take it away. There were 6 people in the car when JFK was shot. Before, if that's what you want to believe or not. The fuck? This is weird shit. No, I'm not okay, man. I'm not okay, dude. This is fucking with my reality, bro. I'm not okay.
Yeah, I'm freaking out, actually. Pretty bad. Happy holidays.
Ooh, book. Open the book. Read the book. Nope. Just look outside then. That creepy little house, dude. Oh, I think I've exhausted all the portals. So I'm actually stuck in the house. Oh no, there's gonna be one up here. Huh, that's pretty weird. No, it looks like you can freely switch between them. Puzzles not your forte, bro. Man, I like puzzles just fine, bro. It's just the Mandela effect, man. It's just got my brain tripping, bro. That's all. Huh. Interesting. Okay. Until you read the thing, I think everything's just a normal house. So let's check this place out. Ooh, pretty view.
Well, he doesn't have any legs. So there's a good chance he died when his legs were chopped off. That's my deductive reasoning skills at work, bro. This room. Only those who discern every true interior to pass. What's on the back? Nothing. Plates, trash. Damn hallway again. Here we go. Damn it. Basement. Abilities. That all gonna take me back to here again. I keep forgetting to look at the damn. What up, Father McGuire? How you doing, man? We're just chilling out, doing some psychic detective shit. Trying to figure out stuff and things. Trying to figure out where the thing went. The stuff and Mandela it. Get a drink of water real quick. Okay.
What did you do? What did you wake up?
Nothing. I found a room. I walked into it. That's it.
Damn, Dirk. Be nice to Father, dude. He's alright. He's just dropping by to say hi, bro. Right. You ain't gotta be all harsh like that.
Something,
Fuck, man.
Something coming from the Vandegrift house.
These two houses are connected to each other. Hello.
You need to talk to your son. He was poking around in the old Vandegrift house again. Said he found some secret room.
Yeah, really? Okay, I will go talk to him.
Oh yeah? Gonna Mandela me, huh? Gonna Mandela me right out of existence? Well, don't do that, bro.
Pop, they're getting worse.
Be a little harsh,
right?
You're
talking about this thing, this sleeper.
I know. What I don't know is if it's real or not.
Father's all not. Not handling it. Nah, it was directed at me, Father. Don't worry, man. Dirk's angry at me. He's
Travis,
angry at me because we fucking.
Alone.
We took his thing and rolled with it. And now, dude, now it's just gotten completely out of Mandela control.
It wants Ethan.
And all of reality is pretty much turning on top of its head because of what we Mandela'd. Damn Mandela effect, bro. It's like time traveling when you go back and like you fucking.
It's not my fault.
Accidentally fuck up your entire reality.
I didn't mean for any of
you just. Accidentally your whole reality. Oh shit. I'm like fading out of existence right now, man. I'm fucking fading out of existence because oh shit, dude. What have you done, man? Where is it? Hold on. I'm trying to figure. Oh, here we go. Dude, I'm fucking fading out of existence, bro. Why would you do that, dude? Fuck. What the fuck, man? You're destroying me, man. Like, you're Mandela-ing me. I've been Mandela'd. Look at this shit, dude. I'm only half in existence now because of the Mandela effect. God damn it. I am Marty McFly, bro. I've been McFly'd. That's what we're going to call it. We're going to call it the McFly effect.
On behalf of the UAC, welcome to the Gas Stream.
What's up, many masters? How you doing, buddy? Welcome to the Gas Stream. Glad to have you here, man. But, you know, you're coming at an interesting time because I'm being phased out of existence by Dirk's Mandela. So, yeah, we might not be here for that much longer. Oh, man. It's tough being fucking half in and half out of existence, you know? Maybe if I'm going to give Nelson Mandela a call. If he believes in me, then everything will be good. You know what, guys? If you believe in fairies, clap your hands. And if you all clap your hands and we can hear it, then I'll be restored to existence, just like a fairy. So clap your hands, everybody. Don't wake up your parents or anything. But clap your hands. Come on, I can hear you clapping. I know Detective Error's over there clapping. I can hear him clapping. Clap your hands harder if you believe. If you believe in Gaddingtons. Clap your hands harder if you believe in Kennedy. If you believe in Kennedy, if you believe in Mandela, if you believe in Forrest Gump, clap your hands. Clap your hands. See, the clapping worked. Look at that. The clapping fucking worked. All right, guys, you've clapped me back into existence. But I seem to have... I have the clap now, so that fucking sucks, but, alright, well, you know what, dude, I'll take existing with the clap over just not existing at all. Honestly, that's better, when you think about it, it's better. Damn, dude, you got your graveyard right in front of your fucking house? That's not classy, that's fucked up. Look at that shit. Everybody hold your breath so we don't end up in this graveyard when we die. Clap your hands, guys. Oh my god. What is going on right now? That's the clap your hands song. I'm Claptown. Damn, I got the fucking clap, dude. Well, how about we solve how I got the fucking clap, dude? I think you gave me the clap, man. By fucking Mandela-ing me. You mean I don't just get to run around and shoot people in the face? Gotta solve shit. Solve what? Solve that mystery of the dude with no legs? He's got no legs, man. Mystery solved. Maybe if he had some legs, he would have been able to run away from whatever fucked him up. Go back to the tracks. Alright, we're going back to the tracks. I'm upset. I don't mean to be triggering you, man, if I am. But this mystery is intense. And I'm just trying to explore the place, man. You know, I dropped into the game a few minutes ago, and you're expecting me to just Sherlock Holmes this shit right away, bro. You're all like, well, I've already played through this game, so how come you're not getting it? Well, because I haven't fucking gotten through it yet, bro. Besides, I did piece together that this is the old Vandergraaf house, and that all those portals lead between the two homes. So, alright, that's one step in the right direction. We know that. We know that the Vandergraaf home is linked to this other home. And we know that there were six people in the car with Kennedy. And we know that Luke Skywalker is Jesus Christ. So, and we know that those brownies we made were like 700,000 calories apiece. And we know that if you clap, you can bring someone back from the brink of being wiped out of extinction. I know, Dirk. Much love, dude. It's all just shit talk, you know. I've stepped through too many
worlds simultaneously. Bits and pieces of me stay on the other side, waiting.
Yo, that's fair enough.
and bring parts of those worlds back.
Just like Luke Skywalker, man.
They're sad, evicted things. Memories without homes.
Just like Luke Skywalker's. I told you, it all leads back to Luke, man. All leads back to Luke fucking Skywalker. You've triggered me, Sonny. I'm triggered. We're all triggered. Scary girls waves with MP5s. What? What? How does that relate to the mystery? Louvre? What? How does that relate to the mystery? What are you talking about? We're trying to solve the mystery here of how fucking Luke Skywalker ended up leaving pieces of himself in many different worlds and became Jesus. We're going to read this. Move it around a little bit. All right, we're going to go through the portals now. We're going to go in the other house and we're going to see what's up. That's from the other house. Now we're in the other house. Now we're back in the neighbor's house. See, look. Boom. That's the house we walked into, but now we're in the other house. What? What, you might be thinking to yourself? You might be thinking, what the fuck is going on? But that's only because I haven't explained the whole plot to you yet. But I will. See? First we need to go up on this rafter. And we gotta say the magical prayer. Luke Skywalker, I invoke your power. Then we gotta go up to this magic door. Choose the right interior. That looks like the interior I'm in. This one, this should have us back in there as well. No, that's, whoa, what? Yeah, that's the true interior. So, that's great. Maybe I'm just tripping. Oh, sweet, I get to be Laura Croft? Boop, that's what I got to say about that. Okay, there's the house. Okay, good. So, I'm going around here. That one looks back on itself. Look at that shit. That one goes to there. See what I'm saying? Boom. I'm not sure what that's going to, but that might be going to its actual room. So let's check. That lead us? No, that did not lead us to the actual room. Damn. So now we're fucked. Now we're gonna have to go back to the original doorway. Oh no, here we go. Get back up in here. Oh, crap. No, we fucked it up. Because now the only way out will lead us back to the original doorway. No, we fucked it up, dude. We fucked it up. Just gotta solve that shit, bro. Just gotta solve it. Boom. Alright, so we're in the house. So, all right, let's go study that other house for a minute. Dude, we are gonna solve the fuck out of it. We're in Van Helsing's crib, and this other house over here is the Kennedy house, where Kennedy lives, with Gandhi and Nelson Mandela. Well, he lived with Nelson Mandela. That was until Mandela died in the 80s in prison. At which point he forfeited his lease. Okay, so this house, here's the bottom floor. We gotta run around and sort of see what this house looks like. Kitchen's over here. Get a feel for the layout of this house so that we can decide on the true interiors when we come back through the portals. Okay. Come on up here. There's this room that leads around the back. Stairs again, okay. This is where that hallway is. Get a room. Get a room with the plates. And then the top floor has this crazy room, this crazy attic room. Okay. So now that we've refreshed our minds on how this house is laid out, we want to go back into the... The what? Man, see, I've already forgotten who lived in the original house. Fucking... I think it was Link. Link and Zelda live in this house over here, so... We'll go over here. There we go. Looking for Link. And Zelda. Link, Zelda, where you at? Link and Zelda, where you at? Link, yeah. Alright, so we read the thing right. Now, we're supposed to determine the true interiors as we look at it. So that's not the room that's connected over there. Not even a little bit. So we're over here. Nope. Yes, the kitchen is connected here. So that's correct. Now we go back through the hallway. Front hallway. I think that one's the right one. Yeah, this is the correct one. Boom. Now we're zapped. Okay. Now this one is going the wrong place. Oh, crap. I forget what's in there, but I think it's that one. So we're going to go through this one because... Whoa. Yeah, that's right. So that sets us up. That's good. I'm not gonna fuck with that one right now because I'm confused about it. This one I think I can remember easy though. That's not it. Yeah, this is where that hall is. It's got a little fucked up room. Yep. Yep. With the plates. And now we... Okay, so we're laying them all out. Did I just fuck it up? I think I may have just fucked it up. Yeah, it gave me the red. I think I just fucked that up big time. So we're illuminating the portals as we go. Now we come over here. So now the house should be constructed correctly. I think. Let's see if there's any portals left. Oh yeah, there was one down on the first floor that I had gotten incorrectly. Go all the way back down and take care of that. And that should reveal all the great mysteries of our time. Oh, the great mysteries. If you choose a wrong room, then it sends you back into... Ah, there we go. It sends you back into the original house with the page at the beginning. So now, boom, see what happened? We set up all the shit, set up all the rooms correctly, and boom. All right, now you're gonna fuck off, dude. Look, dude, we just solved your fucking riddle, man. We just solved your mystery, Dirk. Fucking Dirk, no patience, man. Look, there's a fetus and shit, dude. I know you're all about fetuses, Dirk. Damn, they burned his house down?
Why are you standing there? You spying?
No.
Yeah.
No. What the hell's wrong?
Oh, here we go. Ghostbuster song time.
Nothing.
You need to stop leaving your stupid stories around. You're freaking everyone out.
Freaking everyone out. Neighborhood. Who you gonna call? Ghostbusters. Who you gonna call? Nelson Mandela. Afraid of no Kennedys on a grassy knoll. Ghostbusters. Not the new ones though. Don't call the new ones because they ain't gonna do shit for you. They'll just show up and be annoying. Okay. Father ain't afraid of no ghosts. Oh, that's the same thing. Okay, cool. Boom. Open it. Yeah. Now we in the magician's house, homie. Homie G's. Oh, this is the original house. Well, that's why the kid was talking about finding secret rooms and shit up in the Vandergraff house. The Vandergraff generators everywhere, making sparks. Alright, well, mystery of the old ghetto house solved. Oh look, and now the table's gone. Damn, solved the fuck out of that mystery, bro. Ghost busting. Ghostbusters. Call 'em. Oh well, this didn't really solve the mystery of why that dude didn't have no legs. Really didn't, but you know what? I'm okay with that. We're gonna roll up this way now. Cause the church didn't have any mysteries, it just had death. Go back and lick the legless guy? Alright, we'll lick him. We can lick the legless guy if you really want, if that's, you know. If that's what's going on, dude. A little necrophilia thrown in for good measure. Let's do it. Mmm. Yum. Ooh, yeah, lick that legless guy. This makes me think of the, the fucking sentient turds in SCP that were chasing us around. Giant sentient turds with eyes that could teleport. Teleport like Watson to get your ass. Are you gonna call Ghostbusters? That is a damn good song, though. Alright. Back to this legless motherfucker, dude. I don't think there's anything going on with him, though. I think he's just dead as fuck. He's gonna stay dead as fuck. His situation ain't changing anytime soon. That's why I was gonna run down to the next house and see what was going on. Maybe get some weed. Grow some weed, since no one's around. This seems to be pretty fertile soil. Grow some weed out here. Get back in the space capsule. What was that space capsule shit all about, dude? We went on like a 2001 journey into the cosmos, and it had no bearing on the legless guy. Is that how he lost his legs? Was space travel? Space travel? Man, I don't even know if I can find this legless dude again, man.
I have no legs. I have no legs.
Oh, hell yeah, dude. Is this the MC Hammer? No. That is the MC Hammer version. I got all hyped for a second.
They do what they want to do. Play how they want to play. Sing how they want to sing. Dance how they want to dance. Adam's Family.
Alright, he's right over here. Legless McGee. Boom! Let's touch him. I'm gonna touch it. I'm touching him all kinds. Touching him on the butt. Pretty much specifically, just touching his butt. Touch his leg with butt. Not really okay with just feeling up this legless dude, man. Gotta be honest. This isn't really okay, bro. Just happened. Sound just died. Hold on. There he goes. See, dude, I touched the body too much, man. I spent too much time touching his butt. Yeah, that's Glenn, dude. Glenn got smashed over here, unfortunately. Fucking Negan and his vampire bat were here. Well, this guy doesn't have a skeleton, man. No wonder he's got problems. He's got no spoopy. No spoopy, bro? Poor bastard. Nah, it's never too soon, man. We all miss Glenn. Did you see there was a video of him and, jeez. Late. I'm spacing names. Him and the big blonde guy both wearing their head bashed in makeup. Glenn sitting there with his eye all popped out and he's all, I feel fine. Shit was funny. There's another one where they're saying goodbye to Glenn and like they're hugging him and stuff, and one dude Andrew I think rolls up and fucking just starts like he kisses him and starts like feeling on his chest, and Glenn's face is like, I don't like this too much. Shit was fucking funny, man. Yeah, bro. Walking Dead, man, served up some serious blows. Although this last episode was pretty, pretty chill. Pretty lighthearted. What do you think about King Ezekiel, man? I like King Ezekiel. I hope he doesn't get killed real fast, because he's got a sweet-ass tiger. Honestly, King Ezekiel, he's neat, but it's the tiger that really, like, that I think is fucking cool. The tiger's really the main event for me. A tiger in the apocalypse? I say fuck yeah. They definitely got some weird shit going on though. I'm interested to see where it goes. Rick having to answer to somebody is... It just doesn't seem like Rick's style, man. It just doesn't seem like he'll deal with that too well. if you're a comic reader, then you know kind of the direction that they're going. I mean, I think. But if you're not, then shit's up in the air. Shit's all over the place. Who knows? Anything could happen, man. Whatever you want to believe about it is just as true as anything else. It's just as true. The truth is out there, bro. X-Files and shit. Just like Mulder always said, the truth is out there. Well, touching on that dude's body revealed nothing. Maybe I just did it wrong. Maybe I was just not touching him correctly. Yeah, but, you know, it's okay. I'm going to go down to where the dude was talking and saying poetry, and we're going to see what happens from there. That's fair enough, man. That's fair enough, DE. That is fair enough. I can't argue with that assessment. There's a good chance it never happened. In fact, I don't even remember what we were talking about, and that means it doesn't exist. The Walking Dead just doesn't exist. What's The Walking Dead? The Walking what? It's a contradiction. Dead can't walk. You're crazy, DE. Stop fucking with my head. Yeah, let's go up the road less traveled here. This is the one that you need a Jeep to go up. Look at this rocky surface, bro. You take your Toyota Camry up here, bro, you're gonna fuck up your suspension and your undercarriage, man. Look, that's a fucking exhaust-destroying rock right there. This is a walking dirt bike ATV-only kind of track. Maybe your sweet-ass 4Runner will make it up here, but don't be coming up here in your fucking Lexus, dude. Look, that'll fuck your Lexus right up. Shit, that'll fuck up your ATV. That's a fucking burly old rock in the road. House? Wait. Did it just walk my ass around in a circle? I'm pretty sure it just walked my ass around in a circle. It threw my ass in a circle, dude. Twerk it, twerk it, twerk it, twerk it, twerk it, twerk it. Oh yeah, Dirk's Explorer opening, no problem. Yep, threw my ass in a circle, dude. Fuck. You're kidding me. Just twerked. So where's the house? That's the real question. Where's the house? Oh, there we go. I guess I missed it because I was busy throwing my ass in a circle. Sweet dude. Oh, come on. Kick that shit in. Kick in those rusty bullshits. I need a key, don't I? Yes, I do. Happy holidays, bro. Halloween's over. That means that it's officially the holiday season.
What do the dead have to say?
Oh, here we go.
You'd be surprised by how little they know. The dead can't explain what it means to be dead.
Dumbass dead.
They walk down stairs that disappear beneath their feet.
Foolish.
Headed for a bright blade of memory they'll never reach.
Fucking dead, man. Walking dead, they don't know shit. Oh yeah, into the forest. Let's find another spaceman spiff. Or not.
Okay, maybe not. Oh, good. Here's a house, looks like. I think this is the church we were at before. Alright, let's discover the mystery of this church. Merry Christmas. Oh, Merry Christmas, man. Happy holidays. You know? A joyous Kwanzaa. Yeah, mystery games, dude, that's the whole point, dude, is, you know, it's slow and you solve the mystery in a beautiful environment. That's what I was saying, it just makes me think of Mist. Very Mist-like. Oh, sweet. Tomb. Closed tomb. There's the graveyard. Ooh, inspect. I'm definitely gonna inspect this. Oil lamp? Yes, baby. Give me it. Oil lamp? Oil lamp? Oil lamp? It's a fucking oil lamp, bro! It's an oil lamp! Oh, fuck! Why, dude? I guess it's an oil lamp. Can I take it? No? Just wants to flip out about the oil lamp. Get hype! It's oil lamp time! It's oil lamp time! So yeah, I don't think there's anything going on in this bitch. Except for a dark as fuck vestibule. I'm loving the ray tracing though. The graphics are sweet. Alright. Let's go down to that open motherfucker. Let's inspect it. Yeah, oil lamp. No, don't just... Okay, don't just tell me it's an oil lamp. Let me pick up the fucking oil lamp. I get that it's an oil lamp, dude. Oh, fuck. Someone's building a wall? Building a wall? Building a wall! Holy shit, they're building a wall! They were gonna wall off this tomb, see? Okay, well. I would use an oil lamp if I could. Crow? Crow? Alright. I think I probably need an oil lamp, you know what I'm saying? What? I'm gonna need an oil lamp for this. Come on, where's the gimme it button? Gimme it. That's so stupid. Dirk, how do I grab the oil lamp? Or the wheelbarrow? So we'll just walk into the... We'll just walk into the darkness. No? Nope. We're gonna have to go into the graveyard. Find more of our oil lamp situation here. Graves? 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 Mine? 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 Here we go. Oh. Several different footprints. It's got nothing to do with our boy. Our boy's got no legs, so... It wasn't him. You know? That's just deductive reasoning, yo. No legs, you ain't leaving footprints. Unless he left footprints before he lost his legs. Not possible. He definitely lost his legs first. And then left footprints. It's Luke Skywalker, dude. Nope, I don't know where the... I don't know where the thing is. Bloodstain's not useful.
Ooh, we need to go further down the hill.
People come here for many reasons. They want to ask me questions about the future.
Yeah, well, I do too.
I can see the future. So it is the past that interests me.
I already know about that.
If you want to find my house, you must answer the questions I ask of you.
Okay. What it is.
Death bring peace or suffering?
Depends on the life you've led, homie. Ow.
Would you prefer anonymity over notoriety?
Well, yeah. Anonymity every time. Fuck being hated.
Do you feel victory when your words cause pain?
No. Not particularly.
Do you take that which you know you will not return?
Yeah. Yeah, pretty regularly, actually.
Is betrayal caused by inequality or injustice?
Injustice.
Does sin come from the heart or the mind?
The heart. Sweet. Answered it all. Boom, bitch. That's what you get. Beautiful woman sat by a river. A witch approached and told the woman she was to have a child. The woman began to cry with joy, but the joy turned to fear, and she could not stop crying. Fear turned to sadness. The woman continued to cry. Sadness led to anger. Anger led to the dark side. She cried for months, hardly sleeping, until the child was born, but the crying had aged the woman, and she was no longer beautiful. When he was old enough, her son climbed the mountain to find the home of the witch. He asked her if she could make his mother beautiful again. The witch said, "Fuck no, dude." The witch asked the boy many questions after hearing the answers. The witch told the boy she had lied to the mother about her child. The boy disappeared and the mother was beautiful again. Bam. So, in the end, she could. I started writing this, but it wasn't good because fear turned into anger and then the dark side.
Why?
Oh, it lets you read it like that. That's cool.
Ethan, the point of life is not to rock the boat. Just try to get along. Stop living in your head. Do something real. That's what people respond to. Reality.
Reality, bro. All about the reality shows, reality TV, reality games. Ethan, honey, I'm sorry I yelled at you. I want you to keep this note and read it every time I lose my temper. I don't mean it. I know I got a snake's tongue. You're my little guy, my precious bean. You just gotta pull your head out of your fucking ass, okay? Love, Mom. Jesus, Mom. Talk about a backhanded apology. Thanks, Mom. Bitch. Jeez, every time, you know what I mean? That's a mom for you, dude. Just, I'm sorry, but you were in the wrong. Oh, thanks, Mom. Great, great apology. Way to be. Way to be, Mom. Maybe you shouldn't have gotten Dad killed with your bullshit and gotten old. Where the fuck am I now? Okay. I'm gonna go this way. Because it looks chill out here. More stuff to inspect? No? Let's look into the sun for a while. Mama, that's where the fun is! Oh, there's the main bridge. Okay, so the house is right back over here then. That's good. What the fuck? Can we take it? No. That was very Oracle-like. First, you must answer questions 3. Subjectively as hell. I must have answered incorrectly. Should have answered better. Damn. So rude. Some people, man, they just don't, you know. They just don't. Is this the church again? Okay, good. Maybe now we can do something with the oil lamp now that we've answered the questions and stuff. Oil lamp time. Okay. Is there more going on in here now that we've talked with Mom? Mom, damn it. You
You wasted my time. You were unhelpful. You did make me feel... Oh, here we go. Oil lamp. Take it. Perfect. Oh, it's broken. That sucks. Damn it, Mom. You had one job, and it was to take care of the freaking oil lamp. Oil lamp? Oil lamp? Alright, let's go back over here where the oil lamp residue was, and everybody was talking about the oil lamp. Oil lamp. Okay, I'm bringing you to oil lamp. Here we go. Blah. Fix it. Great. Okay. Didn't sort out of our problems. Okay, oil lamp, come with me. Damn it. Are you fixed or what? No. What is going on back over here? Did you see that shit? Whoa. Making a sacrifice to Kleepoth. Of course, bro. Of course, a sacrifice to Kleepoth. How did I not see it earlier? Kleepoth, man. It just... so fucking obvious, dude. Alright. Kleepoth. No, I still don't get it. Just pretending. Just gonna have to fake it till I make it. Gotta be more stuff to look at. What if I fixes the oil lamp and then leaves it there? It's fixed. There's not a dark room over there or anything where I need it. I bet I have to run all the way back to that body now. Oh, look. Here we go, a road. Nope, this is the road I found to get down here. What do you think, DE? Have I missed an important clue concerning Kleepoth? I'd say most definitely, right? Kleepoth clue. Cluedo Kleepoth. Yes. Yes, it has. It's been missed. Just want to switch weapons to my knife so I can run faster, you know? That's all. That's all I want. Okay, there's gonna be something down here that I can work with. I can burn the body in the oil lamp. Collect the essential oils from the body. Oh, here we go. A cave system. Dude, it's spelunking time. Dude, I've been wanting a cave I could go inside of fucking this whole game. So this is really delivering for me right now. Off we go into the cave. Pretty sweet cave, dude. Oh, nice, look. Dude. Yes, bro. That's exactly what we were trying to get into. Awesome. And what do we need an oil lamp for when there's fucking electric lights that are just on all the time? Have been since the dawn of time.
Oh, this is super Skyrim right here. Dwemer ruins, baby. Oh, we are so gonna get some sweet Dwemer gear out of this. I'm not taking that yet, though. Okay, I guess I am. It's Dwemer gear time. I'll just trust this elevator. Dude, I would never trust some random fucking underground elevator. Dude, that's scare the shit out of me, man. No. I'm not doing an underground elevator, dude. In some abandoned ass fucking mine in the middle of nowhere. Nah, dude. That's inviting death on a whole other level. On a whole other level, dude. Inviting the death. Kill me, said my character. Ooh, we're going deep, too. I want one of those spiders. Those Dwemer spiders. That's what I'm down here to get. Only scared if the lights go out, which they will, unless I manage to recover the part I need for the oil lamp. But since I'm only just gonna leave that oil lamp off there. Oh sweet, dude, check this place out. This place is badass. Oh yes, I will inspect a pickaxe rack. That's a pickaxe rack. Pickaxe. What the pickaxe? Pickaxe. Where's the pickaxe? Where'd your pickaxe go? What'd you do with the pickaxe? Oh, sweet. Boom. Let's drag it up, baby. I bet there's a pickaxe in there. Nope, just the body. Lock broken from the outside. Antemortem? Aw, dude. Power sucks. That's two bodies laying around so far. Smash through some rocks, baby. Smashed! Oh, yeah. That's what I'm talking about right there. Looks like that's fine. Yeah, looks like that's good to go. Cool. All right, let's inspect. No, no inspecting. Oh, because I gotta put the light on it. Maybe I missed my chance to inspect it, I don't know. Well, there's the other pickaxe. It's dark in there. Oh yeah, web fuel, good call. Probably turn it off so I don't waste all the gas, huh? Looks like I move faster on my feet than I do with that dumb thing. Cool. Smells like poo. Stinky.
I could feel two kinds of darkness here in Red Creek Valley. The first you walked into, and with any luck, walked out of. But the other darkness was deeper, stickier, unknowable. And it wanted me to leave.
Yes, dude! Pinderschlosh! Bro. Fucking... mission achieved, bro. Achievement. Castle Pinderschlosh reached. How fucking sweet is that, right? Oh, a wall-mounted case where an axe used to be. Could it be a fire axe cabinet? Where's the axe, though? Where's the axe? Where's the axe? Where's the axe? Where's the axe? Where's the axe, though? But where's the axe, though? Oh, there's the axe. Sweet, let's take that, bitch. Yes! Thank you. Oh no, not an overturned pen holder. Do you think there was a struggle or something? Was someone hurt here? Maybe somebody got hurt here. There might have been some sort of fight or something? No, I don't think so. No signs of struggle. So many questions. Did he have hemorrhoids? Perhaps diarrhea? Looks like he's laying in a puddle of his own diarrhea. Fuck it, I got an axe. Know what I'm saying, bro? Like, dude, Castle Pinderschloss is not as great as I thought it was gonna be. Oh, come on, let me into larger parts of it. That's it, just that one little room. Come on, that looks like I can go inside there. Oh yeah, there we go.
Seriously? Fuck Pinder Schloss. This fucking castle sucks. I wanted to see all kinds of stuff inside of there. Look, there's a big old, like, machine and shit. What if we use the axe? Smash a window. I think that's it, though. You're supposed to figure out. Well, I'll just put that back then. You know, what good is an axe to me? It's no good, really. In the end, it's not only like the most badass weapon I've got. I'm here just cuz, man. I'm here cuz I was transported in a fucking spaceship. Because I love beautiful places. Ooh, let's go see if we can go into the damn house. Damn house will reveal some shit. Yes! No! Are you serious? Let's go back and get the axe, chop that door in. Nope. Don't be bothering me with chronological order of things, man. I know I didn't get into the spaceship till after I arrived. So? That's still... You know what, dude? I believe that it happened in that order. I believe that I got in the spaceship and then I arrived. So, explain that then. What do you got now? I just changed the whole reality, dude. You died in prison in the 80s, so I just changed the whole reality, bro. You're gonna fade out any minute now, remember? Remember what happened, dude? You fade. You fade to like 50%, and that's that. Back here just a little ways. That's not it. This one. Okay, well, you know what? That's cool, then. You don't fade out of existence. Boom, I just changed that reality, too. Three snaps all around, just like that, bro. Sorted. So, I guess you can thank me later
for your continued existence and stuff. This warning, if this warning stands, walk no further. If this warning stands, our ritual failed. If this warning stands, the Sea Thing gate remains sealed. So I should just walk in here, yeah? Yeah? Oh, here we go, there's a map. Study that for a second.
So we can see where we're going.
And off we go. Candles, bro? Candles? Seriously? Candles last for like 12 hours at most, kind of thing. You're telling me these candles are just eternally burning down here? Come on, man. Alright, let's go into the big chamber and find out what is really going on with the Candle Town. Whoop, what did I just do? There we go. Boom. Dude. He's not dead, but eternal lie. Oh man, and he burned up the fucking important runes. The god of strange aeons cannot die. We open the gate of old. Its guardian eyes have long grown cold. The name of our god, our truth, our key. He is that which is, which should not be. Or is he? Oops, whoops. Oh, sorry, shit. Hold up, dude. Wait, bro. Shit, wait up, homie. I'm coming with, bro. I'm coming with. Yes! What up, G? Oh, let's do our thing. I'll stand here. Sense? Okay, maybe I won't stand inside of you. Oh, what, dude? Okay, so. Okay, this is pretty neat. Oh, okay, so. Okay, so. And I'll start it with the B. So we read his thing down here. And then he's just standing on one of them, which is going to be important in a second. So come down here. Bonk. Read his thing. Starts with the B, ends with the M. Starts with the B, ends with the M. Now let's find the line that begins with B and M. BM. House score, dude.
backwards E. That thing. Z E E. Crap, I was hoping that was it. Nope. So, what's up with this thing? Bro, give me some fucking clues, man. You look like you fucking... look like a ghoul from Fallout. Figure it out, bro. Just like that. Who's the man? Uh-oh. Tentacle things. Oh, man. Now we're drowning. Dude. I just flooded the shit out of that valley. It's cool because I can still breathe and shit. I'm all good. I'm gonna hop in this tractor. Read? I'm underwater. I'll just read. I'm already dead. Curse the sea thing. Noki and Necronomicon, the iron ore miners, had finally found it, but not all of them wanted to perform its ritual and summon the sea thing, Gnae. One miner realized the ritual would unleash Gnae's flood upon this world, and so the miner had no choice but to stab the others with the shards of magic felt down. Gnae, in response, cursed the miner, who now wanders the mine, doomed to prevent others from summoning the sea thing and flooding the world forever. Well, except for me, who did do it.
Ethan, I told you to stay out. God damn it. Look, Ethan, it's dangerous in here.
You shouldn't have flooded that fucking valley.
Okay. And, please don't tell your mother I'm in here.
Look, dude, right? Just okay. Finish it up, man, and get out.
Get back
dude.
Home.
Okay. Heading home. Boom. Done. Look at that. Curse of the Sea thing. All set, bro. All set. Like, get your shit out of our basement and bring it to the goddamn dump. I'm so sick of stepping over your lifetime of failure on my way to the washing machine. I'm not kidding. Either you move it or I burn it. Mother. Okay, mother. Thank you for those words of encouragement. Okay. Well, that was an interesting little... oh, good. Really fucking weird. Well, we're back at our cart at least. I guess we didn't flood the whole valley after all. So that was good of us not to do that. Charmé. Thank you.
worried that shit'll run out of gas. Fixed it. Now maybe if I touch the body a little more. Yeah, boom, look at that. Crap. Doing stuff.
Why wouldn't he? Why would he be here? Shit. That was probably a raccoon.
No. No, I don't think it was.
Oh. Okay, so I had him wrong. So, this is two then. Two. Three. Four, five. Let's try that.
Honey, he probably ran. Why wouldn't... He's just a kid. He didn't disturb anything. He just found a room in an old house. That's it!
Oh boy, is the price. I'm going up there. The sleeper must not sleep.
But he's a sleeper. That's what he does. Okay, so then...
Clearly, the sleeper breathes inside me.
You're sick.
What, bitch?
We all are.
Dale!
What are you talking about?
What are you doing?
I'm sick of your shit, bitch. I'm gonna kill you. Fixing something I should have fixed a long time ago.
Dale, you miserable coward! Let me out! The sleeper demands to rise! The sleeper must wake up! The sleeper must wake up! The sleeper must...
Oh well.
Mom, I thought I heard her voice.
She's, still looking for you. You need to leave. Go through there.
Through that water? It kind of looks like it's boiling.
No, it's just a simple chemical reaction. It's not actually boiling.
Mom! Mom! Where are you?
I'll deal with your brother. Just go, now.
Okay.
He didn't kill his wife. She was no longer who she once was. Neither was he. Something was using all this pain and death. Something was becoming stronger.
Grass back down in the motherfucking muck. Deuce's dead body. Law. Okay. Well, I'm not really sure what we revealed about anything, but let's go back up and I guess check on the body in the Pinterschloss house. See what we're working with now that we've got the fucking psychic powers. Messages. But I don't give a fuck about that cause I'm streaming my shit. Alright, out we go. Alright. Now, let's go back and look at that dead body. Wait. No. I want to go look at the dead body on the other side of this cave thing. Oh, okay. I get it. I went to the one side too quickly. Thank you.
Okay. Now, here's where I messed up. I need to go all the way back down. Oh, Lieutenant, forget about it, bro. I already forgot about you, so you don't even exist anymore. That's why your hand started fading out right before your eyes. I need to go all the way back down that damn fucking tunnel now. And you missed a pretty amazing cutscene where we watched the dad murder his wife for some reason. I guess she was possessed by the entity or whatever. So. Down there, we got like a, I don't know. No, it was just because I almost forgot about you. But we got like a cutscene that basically showed us that the husband killed his wife before the kid could find out, really. Because she was like possessed by the fucking, the sleeper is what she called it. The sleeper had possessed her. So now we're going to go down, and we had discovered ourselves a new power to rebuild the scenario all Sherlock Holmes style, just from looking at what's going on. So we're going to go use it on the dude who is slaughtered with the axe. We'll see what's happening. We'll see what's happening. Good call, probably, dude. I'm probably the kid returning to the... I'm Ethan. We're looking for Ethan. No, I think Ethan's the kid, dude. I think Ethan is the vanished kid. And I'm going to assume that we've been given all of our context from the title of the game. The Vanishing of Ethan Hawke. Because we're trying to find Ethan Hawke. So that he can... act in Gattaca or something. I don't even know. I'm going to go back here and I'm going to try and use my power again. And you're going to be like, whoa. You're going to be so amazed at the power. It's going to amaze you. It's an axe. That's an axe. Just in case you didn't know what an axe is. So now we're going to go to this guy and we're going to touch him. And we're going to hold it and we're going to let it really expand out. No, not yet. Oh, come on. We're so close to having all of the information. Okay, so we gotta find the pencil or something like that. There's the scissors. That's what we're looking for, were the scissors that fell out of the cup that he was stabbed with. Do it, bro. You won't. No balls, bro. You won't use your power. But I tried to, man. I tried to. I didn't hesitate. Oh, you can't even jump. Kill yourself. And look where we are again. Okay. So now we've got an elevator that goes up and down. That's cool. So I'm gonna go back down there and use the scissors to solve the mystery of the dude's body. You're just gonna have to go back and watch the replay on the stream, man. But here's the thing about that, dude. At this point, the replay on the stream has probably changed depending on what I believed or you believed happened at that point, so the chances that it'll still be there? Slim to none, because... Just like when, Darth Vader said something different last time I watched the thing. Because it changes. Every time you watch the VHS, it changes. I have all my shit on VHS. Because I believe it's a more pure art form if it's in VHS. We're going to use these scissors and we're going to stab the hell out of the dude. I think this is the husband laying up here in the place. Stabbed with the scissors. See, here we go. Yeah, scissors. So we fix that, right? And then we can do this. Yeah, there we go. Yo. You just got Mandela'd, bro. You just got Mandela'd. What the fuck is going on? I'm getting Mandela'd. Oh, look, here we go. So you gotta watch these things. And then you have to recreate the whole thing. It's pretty cool. First, you gotta find all the places where some shit went down. Then, you gotta Mandela it, bro. So you gotta tag it. This one's one, obviously. Two. Come on, this one's easy. Three. Yeah, I got a separate machine that rewinds them. Four. And five. And then you visualize it and check it out. It'll take you through the whole thing. No way, bro.
Why are you standing in the sleeper's way?
She had an accident. Travis, put down the axe.
He just tried to swing an axe at that kid's head, bro. Why would he believe shit you have to say?
I didn't want her to get hurt. Oh, so sick. You know, since Ethan found that room.
Where's Ethan, goddammit? Talk to me!
Okay! He wants to burn Vandergriff's room. Look, Travis, just leave me alone! Oh, God. Oh, God!
The sleeper chooses vessels. You know that? To enact his wishes, he chose Mom. He chose me.
See the sleeper.
Son, I don't want to hurt you.
You think scissors are gonna save you?
Yes.
It didn't have to be this way. He could have helped the sleeper. Helped us.
Stabbed himself in the neck.
You're a coward, and you'll be meeting Ethan again soon.
See? Now you know what I was talking about when I was talking about that the puts the shit together, it connects the dots for you. And then you get a little bit of the mystery because you're a psychic. Because you're a psychotic, bro. You got psychotic skills, man. And then you gotta follow the psychotic thing. Where you going, psycho? Where you going, psycho? Oh shit, I gotta follow it all the way outside because I'm psycho. Come back, psycho. Boom, that shit ripped off into the distance. Oh good, now the door will be unlockable. Boom, look at that. Now I'm in the damn house.
Travis, we can't get rid of it. I know exactly what we're up against. Don't listen to what's in your head.
Don't listen to what's in your head. Your thoughts are stupid. I'm much smarter than your thoughts. Your thoughts are so stupid.
Sleeper was feeding on them. Their hate, their distrust. Ethan's father figured suicide wouldn't feed it. But it did.
Oh, it did. It's in the sun out there. Fat as a bullfrog. Fat as a bullfrog. Just numbing on that fear and hate and stuff. Fat as fuck. Fat ass bullfrog ass motherfucker. Fat fuck. I don't think we're going to solve this mystery tonight. But I will say, I don't know where I was going with that. I'm sorry. But I will say, people got a Cisco blockhouse. Blocks. Legal table blobs. I'm doing it. I'm turning the thing. Shutting it down, bitch. We're done here. Oh, wait. Stop. Don't do that. Don't turn it back on. Yeah, turning off all the power. What the fuck? Alright, I'm gonna turn it off. Well, that was weird. Why is that locked behind me? Leave that open for now. Now then, now that we've solved all the mysteries, now there's a quick little trail to get back up to the top, so we can, well, we fixed the oil lamp. So maybe now that we fixed the oil lamp, we can go solve the mystery of the legless guy. I think the legless guy was Ethan's big brother, right? There's not a whole lot of people left to die in this mystery before we know who's dead and who's what, and who's not dead. No, I haven't actually, like, it's just still sitting there. You were there when we fixed it, bro. Or fixed it, you know what I mean? When we walked over and did the thing and it just sat on the rock. And it was like, you did it. It played a little song and that was it. That's it. It hasn't gotten any further than that, man. Trust me. Just played the song. Alright. Nah, bro, nothing further has happened with the oil lamp. I promise you that. It's still just same old shit. No, man, I just saw the cutscene with the mom who died because the dad killed the mom, and then the dad killed himself, and now we're just left with Ethan and his big brother, Kevin? Edgar? Whatever the fuck his big brother's name is. Big Brother's kind of a douche and reminds me of the bully from Fallout 3. New Vegas. No, just Fallout 3. Tunnel Snake Bully. He's a Tunnel Snake, bro. Now watch. Watch. Swatch. See the oil lamp still sitting here, dude? Didn't fix a damn thing. Nothing was fixed by any of what I've done so far. Still just a bunch of bullshit down here. Crow? Oh, I gotta go find a crow. Makes sense. I really don't know what the whole spaceship thing had to do with anything. That shit's still, like, uber mystery. So where should I go now, man? I'm not sure where to go. It took me back up to the top with those houses. I guess maybe I'll go check those houses out again and then maybe go back to his dead body and see what's going on. Lick it. Lick the body like Dirk said. Or look around the area for some more clues about that body. Because I'm not really sure, like, once I find the right clues around the body, I can like rebuild the whole scenario. Let's go look at this house again real quick. Maybe there's a lighter in the house. Although I think we solved the mystery of this particular house. I don't think there's anything in here. This house is just a little shitty cottage now. Yep, that's all it is. Alright, so we're gonna go back. I'm gonna go back and check on this body. If this body doesn't result in anything, man, then I think we're gonna put it aside for right now and we'll come back to this tomorrow. Because I'm losing cohesion in terms of brain operation. Brain surgeries. Yeah, we'll figure this shit out tomorrow afternoon. What do you think? How does that sound to you? I haven't been down here yet. Well, and there was a reason. That's how it is? That's how we're gonna do it? Let's roll, dude.
in a blaze of cheddar. That's what I'm talking about. I hope when I touch this body, it gets all crazy. I hope I get more out of it now. Because I didn't get shit out of it this last time. Can you save? You can save. I hope if I exit, it doesn't just dump all my fucking game so far. Concerning his murder. For example, who is this fuckboy? Is this his brother? Yes, this looks like his brother. Okay. So we got the rope. Oh, hey, wait, I got the crank. Yeah, there we go. Okay, no, we want to go backwards. Dude, nice. We robbed me blind. Yeah, we robbed me blind. Yeah, now I got a train, bro. I'm going train riding. I'm going train riding. I'll drive over this rope back here. Ka-chunk, ka-chunk. Damn, that's where his legs are. Severed legs. A rock that he got beat with. We're almost there, though. Just want to keep driving this bitch.
Aha. The divot. Oh, there's the rock. So we're gonna fix it. Boom. Now that we fixed that, I'm pretty sure we can go look at his body. It'll sort us right out. But remember, originally we came over here and that dude fucking ran us off on a crazy magic carpet ride. You gotta fix the thing. Maybe, yeah, I think he starved to death. And then he starved to death on the fucking, on the road here. And that caused him to lose his legs. Because you lose your legs when you starve. Not quite. Not quite yet. Okay, so we gotta continue to follow the trail. Just a little further. And there's the rock. So what are they doing back in here? What were you dopey fucks doing back here in the forest, huh? What were you dopey fucks up to? Must have been up to something. Are you playing hide and seek back here? Is there a cave? Oh no, there's no caves. Jack-offs doing back here. This is like where I was chasing that astronaut dude around. They call me Detective Gat, because I keep a gat in my hat. Never stopping bitches, where you at? Solving all the crimes like Sherlock Holmes. Ah. Here we go. This is why the motherfuckers. Fangs. Gaylord. So I guess he was a homo or something. So what the shit? This got us no closer to an answer about that body. None closer, I say. Basically, I'm looking for the big obvious text, because that's mostly from Michigan. In Michigan, they say Gaylord a lot. It's like a thing they say in Michigan. Gaylord. I had a friend who was named Gaylord. That was his last name. Not so much a friend as an acquaintance. I remember his name was Gabe Gaylord. and it really was not a great name. I felt pretty bad for him. Everybody did, because it was like, damn, bro. Your parents sincerely named you Gaylord? That sucks. He's like, you know, they can't help it. It's their name, too. They got named that as well. Damn it. Still don't have all the information. Maybe this rope is what I'm missing. Yeah, I'm missing something about the rope. Nope, I'm missing something from earlier. Your last name, though, dude? Did your last name changed? Ah, fair enough. Get a change to, like, Fuckwad or something. Farquad. Okay, it's gonna be some piece of shitty evidence right at the beginning. This is why Dirk was like, dude, you can't just go running through the whole damn thing. Because I just fucking ran through the whole damn thing. And missed all the clues. Whoa. That trap being such a dick. Trap startled me. Whoa, more traps. Holy shit. Bro. This is where I started. Pretty nasty traps, dude. What? There we go, there's another one. Okay, gotta spring some more traps. Shit. Let's see the traps. I'm a trap queen. I know, I almost died a couple times there on those traps, but those traps are pretty nasty. Makes me feel okay, I guess, you know. Like, I feel good that I didn't die, but I feel bad that I was startled by them. Well, that wasn't much to go on. Maybe now if I go, I'll see what's going on with them. There we go. Swag. Jeez. There we go. Oh, I gotta move around and do stuff, huh? All kinds of human bones. Damn, it's a straight up boneyard. Ethan Carter wrote, "An old man came to the forest every day to drink sap from the trees. To get there, the old man had to step around many dangerous traps. The villagers believed this old man had hidden a jade amulet in the forest, but the old man wanted the villagers to believe this, because then they would search the forest for the treasure and not drink his sap. One cool fall night, someone set fire to the forest, and the fire spread to the village. The old man escaped the fire by covering himself in sap." That's not a good way to escape a fire. "When he returned to the village, he found all the villagers' bones. The man sat down and cried. Then he found more sap to drink." Okie dokie.
Ethan, I told you, you can't be here.
But Gramp, I wrote something for you.
That's real nice. Thank you.
Just, here, Grandpa.
Just leave it. I'll read it later.
All right, Gramps. Seduces. Bottles. Oh, he was drinking sap. There we go. One dead in house fire. And he was asleep. Carter's husband, Edwin, told investigators he might fall asleep with a lit cigarette. After a heated public hearing, no answers for Vandergriff. Hopefully those were the missing clues I needed. And now I can hop back on the road, go find this dead body. Here's hoping, man. Like, that's really all I can say is I hope that's what I needed from this area to solve the mystery of the legless man. That's what I'm saying, dude. Sap is not the way to go if you're gonna cover yourself in something to save yourself from fire, bro. Sap, it just, it's gonna get super fucking hot and totally, like, it's like covering yourself in fucking polyester, dude. It's just like, man, you're gonna fucking die. A horrible, burning, hot, terrible death, man. Sap. No. No, dude. Bad move. Bad move, bro. But hey, you know what, Grandpa, dude, he knows what he knows, and it's more than I know about sap and fire, so I'm going to assume he had some sort of sap secret that wasn't shared with me in Boy Scouts when it came to sap and fire. Rope. Oh, severed legs. Rail car. Okay, I get that we're looking for the rail car. Touchdown, baby. Touchdown. Now we're going to watch how Legless died. Oh, dude, they're not going all over the damn forest, are they? Come on, man. Oh, come the fuck on, bro. I ain't got time for all this shit. Alright. This one's gonna be five over here, I guarantee it. Yep. Say two is here. I'm gonna say this is three over here. I feel like I heard a bear or something. Let's go for four over here. Four. Five. Six. Let's see if that works.
Listen to me. We can destroy it. I know how.
You can't destroy it, Ethan. You can't destroy time. And that's what he is. He is forever.
Travis, tell me where Ethan is.
Nope, wrong order. Okay, so... So this is two, then.
Gale, honey, I wish there was another way. Travis, tell me where Ethan is, now.
I'm giving the sleeper what he wants, what all of us want. Look, old man, you need to go home.
Douche. Take that, bitch. Yeah, that's what. Oh, man, that's messed up.
Ethan, run, goddamn it. Go! Get out of here! Travis, close your eyes.
Damn, bro. And that's how that worked. We're doing it! We won! Now you know what happened. Boom. And now we get to follow this thing. Where are you going? Oh, dude, just haul ass on me. Just dick out. Fuck. Dicks out for Harambe. Sticks out till Rick's out.
Grandpa?
Grandpa.
Stay away!
I'm sick too. I can feel the sleeper in my head.
Yeah.
Then fight it! I have to destroy the room!
Corvus. I'm sorry. Ethan.
Oh no.
I can't let you.
Yeah, he didn't starve to death. He was beaten with that fucking crank, I guess. Alright. So now we gotta go.
Whatever had turned Ethan's family against him. The grandfather was trying to resist. Age helps against those things that feed on hate. Not because of wisdom
age or helps?
Experience. Because the old are tired. Their hate is less useful.
He was tired, man. He was like, man, I'm too tired for this shit, bro. Just just too fucking tired for this, man. You know, I was like, I was gonna beat you over the head too, Ethan, but then I was like, my arthritis is acting up, dude. I ain't got time for this shit, bro. My old trick knee. It's gonna be raining soon and everything. I'm out. I'm gonna go take a nap in the old haunted house. Okay, so now we know what happened to Ethan. We know what happened to Ethan's brother, Dave, or whatever. We know what happens to his mom and dad, also named Dave. Both of them, Dave and Dave. All three of them were named Dave. We know what happened to, we don't know what happened to Grandpa. Because who gives a fuck, really, right? Fuck Grandpa. Little prick. He's tired. What is going on in this shit? So I guess at this point, let's head back to the church. Sounds like your family. They're all killing each other and shit all the time. Fair. That's fair, man. Alright, so now I guess we're going to head back to the church real quick. And I think that's probably where we're going to leave it for tonight. And let's pick this up tomorrow afternoon. What do you say, man? And we'll see what we get when everybody kills Ethan. Because, yeah, Ethan seems like a little bitch to me. Because, yeah, Dave, and his mom's named Dave, too. So they're all named Dave, and they're all dead at this point, I think? All the Daves have died. Pretty sure all the Daves have died. So now that all the Daves are dead, I don't know. I have no idea what that means. All the Daves are dead. That's a good thing. Because they're all trying to kill Ethan the kid, who hasn't actually disappeared. He's actually still just chilling around here somewhere. Kicking it, chilling like a villain. Well, what was the point of this whole coming up here and some bitch all, oh, I know the future and the past and all that. What was that all about? You know what I mean? That had nothing to do with Dave. So, the fuck to Dave, man. The fuck to Dave. Nothing. None of this served any purpose whatsoever. There's going to be more clues in the area that we'll have to find concerning Dave. Now, I sure hope that quitting this does not result in a complete wipe, because that would suck so bad. Right? I mean, that would be some bullshit. Need to find the crow. That's what we're looking for. There's a crow. A statue crow. Because I think that's the only thing. See? Crow? Probably another Dave is the secret to this whole mystery. There's another Dave involved. And that Dave is the ultimate Dave. The pederfamilias Dave. Come on, Crow, where are you at? I'm trying to think what I haven't explored yet. OG Dave's house? Which one's Dave's house? The Vandergriff house? Is that the one you're talking about? OG Dave! I don't know. I think I have. I think I've been through all through those two houses. I haven't been down to the... Been in there. Yeah, that's the sign right there when the headset starts to go. Been all around old Dave's and young Dave's. There's nothing in any of those. No crows that I can remember. Or, I mean, I wouldn't be surprised if she's laying around on the ground somewhere. Probably down in that, yeah, it's probably down in the wheelhouse. Where I turned off the... because remember, I turned off the dam generator. So I bet it's down there in the wheelhouse. Dude, yeah, man, these are the shit. These are way better than the stock ones, man. They're more comfortable. They fit way better on the ear. Slightly different sound quality, but I found that this surround sound works way better with these. So yeah, I'm hype on the ear cuffs and the little mat at the top. Shit's badass, dude. Shit's badass. All right, so we're gonna go down the elevator to Dave's house. To old Dave's. We're definitely gonna find out that we are old Dave. You know what I mean? You were Dave all along. It was you who was the Dave. Who was the Dave? You were the Dave.
What? I was the Dave?
Yes, you were the Dave.
Fuck.
What if I send it up without me? Is there a crow underneath it? I bet there is. I was the Dave. Okay. No crow. Let's go check the wheelhouse and shit real quick. And if no crow is found, then we shall search tomorrow for the crow. Well, later today, I suppose. After some sleep, when shit's making more sense. So we got the axe. Oh, it's not even trying to tell us about the axe anymore. It's like, yep, axe. You know what an axe is by now. Wait a minute, we already saw this dude's.
Where's Ethan?
God. Oh God. Son? I don't want to
be disturbed. Not me.
Travis, we can get rid of it. I know exactly what we're up against. Don't listen to what's in your head.
Okay. Let's see. Dave was just listening to what was in his head. Kevin, or whatever his name was. Travis. Travis is his fucking... Oh, shit, I wasn't the Dave? Fuck, dude. Well, that changes everything, man. You just Mandela'd the whole Dave situation, bro. Now I'm fucking confused about who was the Dave and who wasn't. To be perfectly frank. Oh, shit. There's a whole area I haven't even explored here. Damn, man. I feel like I really neglected to Dave this situation. I didn't even kind of Dave it up. Were you the Dave then? Is that what happened? You were the Dave all along? Well, I stopped it, so that's good. So... Alright, so there's gonna be something out here, because otherwise why would you be able to come out here? Well, Dave. He would, dude. Dave would be pissed. Dave is rolling in his grave. Dave's rolling in his grave right now. You know I'm tired because I just giggled at that. That absolutely retarded joke. Oh, man. Well, fuck. Crow? Crow? Well, I've inspected the wheelhouse. And not a single Dave, dude. But it's time for me to get some sleep. So I'm gonna go crash out. And I'll be back this afternoon to resolve the mystery of Dave. There's gotta be something to do with this building, right? In the damn place. It has anything? Shit. Oh well. That's all good. I hope that this doesn't make us play through everything again tomorrow, but I don't think it will. It should be all good. Thanks for hanging out with me as late as you did, DE man. I appreciate it, bro. Oh, maybe this is where you need the oil lamp. But you need the crow to get the oil lamp working. You can't pick up the oil lamp. That's the thing, though, dude. You can't pick up the oil lamp. I don't know. But I'm not thinking straight. That's what's going on. And we're gonna figure it out tomorrow, buddy. So, until then, y'all, thanks for hanging out. I'm Gaddington. You're not. Always remember, don't do anything I wouldn't do. And if you do, name it after me. I'll see you later on. Deuces.